Hello and welcome back to Linus and Chuck, where today I'll be introducing you to the Linus score, which is a way that allows me to review swords and other sharp objects and will allow me to give you guys a honest review of those products in order to help you make better consumer decisions. Today I will also be giving you an example of this score in use by showing you my first sword and how it scores on the scale. This scoring system is an adaptation of the Doug score, which YouTuber Doug DeMuro uses to review cars. However, in this case, I'll be applying it to weapons and obviously changing the categories and scoring system. He's one of my very favorite YouTubers, and if you're into cars, be sure to go check him out. There are two categories. The first category is usability, so how useful the katana is, how well you can use it, and there are obviously several subcategories that I'll get into in a second. But the second category is the display score, so how easily can you hang it on your wall and how nice it'll look when you do that. So one is for usability, when you're using the sword, and the other is how nice it's displayed, its history, and how great of a overall sword it is for that purpose. The usability score is on a scale from 0 to 40, and that is because there are four subcategories with 10 points each. The first is sharpness. This is measured by how sharp the sword is compared to other swords when it comes from the factory, so without any additional sharpening, how sharp it is. I am aware that if you're very talented at sharpening swords, then you can definitely add sharpness to even the dullest blade. However, what I'll be reviewing is how you'll be receiving the sword and how I have gotten it from the factory. The next category is performance. A few things go into this, so how heavy the sword is, how durable it is, and how usable it is. The third category under the usability score is quality. With this, I'll be looking at how durable the sword is and how well it will stand up when used over time. The final section of the usability section is practicality. So if it's a longer weapon, it may be less practical than shorter ones because it's more difficult to transport and so on. So sharpness, performance, quality, and practicality are the four items that go into the usability score of the Linus score. The next section is the display score. The first category under the display score is obviously appearance. So if you hang the sword on your wall, how will it look? How does the hardening along the blade look, and a bunch of different features that go into how nice the sword will appear to you. The second category is appeal, which goes into the rarity of the sword. So is this a limited production? Is it a special sword? Does it have history? And so on. The third category includes accessories of the sword. Are there different stands, different display methods, and so on. The final category is one of the most important, which is value. And this will be an overall value of the sword, how its price plays into how it performs and how it looks. So appearance, appeal, accessories, and value all go into the display score. Once you take the display score and the usability score and pack those together, add them up, you'll get the final Linus score, which is on a scale from 0 to 80. Now that I've given you a rundown of the categories, I'll be giving the first katana that I've ever received a Linus score. So let's get into the Linus score with the Daishogun 1095 Steel Katana. The first category is sharpness. This sword is quite sharp. As you've seen in my cut tests, it does a great job of cutting all sorts of things. However, it is not purely focused around sharpness, and therefore it gets a good score, but not an excellent one, of 6 out of 10. The next category is performance, where this sword does really well. It is only hurt by the fact that it is more of a traditional sword, and therefore quite heavy. And it gets a 6 out of 10. Next up is quality, where they did a really great job of making the fit and finish really good, and it gets a 7 out of 10. Next up is practicality. Being a Maru katana and being over a meter in length makes it less practical than, say, shorter weapons, but it still gets a 6 out of 10. This gives it a total usability score of 25 out of 40. Next up, we have appearance, and this really cool clay-hardened tempered blade helps it immensely here. This gives it a total appearance score of 6 out of 10. Next up, we have appeal. This is no rare or high-end sword that is extremely sought after, but it is a very good option, and I think that if you do have the budget for it, is a very appealing option, giving it a 6 out of 10. Next up, accessories. This sword does not come with anything else except for a cloth bag, giving it a 5 out of 10. The final category is value, and this score does great here because it is an awesome mid-range option for anyone looking to either get into swords more seriously or to use as a practice sword. This gives it a 7 out of 10 for the value section, giving it a display score of 24. Adding the usability score and the display score gives this sword a total score of 49 out of 80. So I hope that you find this katana score to be a good way of helping you make more educated purchasing decisions. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials, and don't forget to check out the various other katana and nunchuck related videos that I have on my channel.